Soon, we'll begin to see some of Minnesota's most beloved creatures come out of hibernation.
Different species of bats, bears, turtles, and snakes all hibernate here, and many rely on more than warm weather to wake up. So how do animals know when it's time to come out of hibernation? That's a good question. WCCO's John Lauritsen shows us all the factors that come into play.
Pretty soon, we're going to start to see what? Snakes?
Mm-hmm.
Snakes.
Yeah.
You like snakes or not?
I do like snakes.
You do?
Yep.
This is a gardener snake den.
And if you come across a snake den after a long winter's hibernation, you'll get your fill. Garter snakes hibernate in the hundreds, and in some cases, thousands. And when they wake up, it's like green spaghetti.
Ah, so squirmy and wiggly and yeah. But you don't mind that?
No, they're great.
How do snakes know exactly when it's time?
It's temperature dependent, so they usually get underground before the ground freezes solid.
Lori Nauman is with the DNR. She says snakes stock up on food and then get underground before the ground freezes. Like many animals, they rely on fat deposits to get through the winter and heat to wake them up in the spring.
Definitely some snakes coming out finding sun when it starts to get those sunny spring days.
Many species of frogs and turtles do the same.
Some animals it is temperature dependent and it's weather dependent and daylight dependent, which is the case for snakes. But other animals, it is hormonal.
We have the convenience of an alarm clock. Ground squirrels rely on their brain. Nauman says they rely on the thalamus in the brain to tell them it's time to wake up. In almost all cases of hibernating animals, metabolism, breathing, and heart rates slow down. For some, it drops to 2 beats per minute.
If you pulled them, like for instance ground squirrels, out of the very frozen ground, they would not wake up at all.
But for many hibernating animals in Minnesota, like black bears, it's not a true hibernation. They have their young in the den, so they're still on guard.
They can wake up and be startled, and they can wake up and protect their young.
But they'll stay in their den in that state for 6 months or more, when food sources like berries return.
They can kind of tell that, yeah, food's back on the menu again, I suppose.
So do the black bears.
No stress, get to sleep all the time.
Yeah,
doesn't sound too bad, does it?
I would like to do that once in a while.
Yeah, sounds pretty good. And John says hibernation and migration go hand in hand. Instead of hibernating when food runs out, many birds migrate south. Animals like deer and birds like robins can find food year-round, so they stay awake during the winter months. If you have a good question for John, just email it by going to WCCO.com/links. We should probably show that snake video again.
Yeah, I can't
hear out of
enough.
My left
I know, sorry
ear.
About that.
Yeah.
I'll have to talk to John.